I've got a couple of close mates, both male and female. And surprisingly, females, they can't find a guy. They don't know what they're doing wrong. For my mates, for the blokes, it's expected. We're a dime a dozen, out of luck. But my female friends, they couldn't understand why they couldn't find a guy. And they asked me, "Johnny, why can't I find a guy?" My mates, they asked me, "Dude, why can't I find a chick?" And they didn't know the answer. I knew the answer, and it was nothing to do with them. I've got a couple of awesome mates, and they are single, miserably single, and they are top fucking blokes, man. Nothing like pieces of shit out and about. These guys are top fucking blokes. And they struggle. Hell, struggle's an understatement. If they were struggling, it'll be an improvement. They're just doing nothing at all. They're not even in the game. If you're in the game, you can struggle a bit. They're not even in the game. And much like myself, I'm the same. But I know the reason why they don't. And they asked me, why? Why on earth can't we all find partners? And sadly, I know the answer, and there's nothing I can do about it. But the answer that I gave my mates, and the answer that I gave my female friends, and they're in awe of me. Like, I don't like to talk myself up, but really, if you ever get to sit down with me, you're gonna be gobsmacked. The answer I gave them was, and this is 100% true, ladies and gentlemen, they don't care how good your heart is. They care about how good you're gonna seem when you sit down at a coffee table with them with a group of other people. And once they heard that, they put their thinking cap on and they thought about it for a bit. And they said, "You know what, Johnny? You're absolutely fucking right." Because they told me stories where they would go out and they would, have a first date at a coffee place, something chill, something low key, something to break the ice. And they would sit down, okay, these females would sit down and they would chat with these seemingly nice guys. And there was a few other people around. It was a bit of a group thing, a couple people knew them, and they all sat down together, bit of a nice breaker. And after that, no more contact whatsoever. The guy just didn't bother with the girl. And as soon as she heard me give her that answer, she thought, you know what, that's exactly what would have happened. And I've had mates of mine go on dates with girls, and they've sat down one on one. These ones were one on one, and they sat down with a girl again to break the ice. Have a coffee. They serve a bit of food there. You sit down, a nice little chill place, nothing too spectacular. And they meet, they greet, and after that night, you don't hear from them again, because they shared a few mutuals, and these mutuals didn't have the greatest stuff to say. Next thing you know, sayonara. They don't care about your feelings. They don't care about how good your heart is. They don't care how great your personality can be. They don't care about none of that stuff. To them, all that stuff is hot garbage. They don't care. What they care about is status. If you have a status, they will hang off your dick like no tomorrow. They will hang off you until the end of time if you have a status. If people know you at a cafe joint, if they scream your name from 500 meters away, if you are well known within a society, a group of people, a so-called gang, if you will, a gang of people, you know, groups, if you are popular, they will want to know you. Hell, they'd want to suck your fucking dick. Okay, and it's the same for women. They can be drop dead fucking stunning as ever. If they're going to sit down and they don't really know a lot of people, you know, they're just, they keep to themselves, it's very likely that the person on the other side is just going to say, you know what, have a good one. That's it after that. Sayonara. It's bullshit. It is bullshit, but it's true. It's been happening to me all my life. Okay, it's all about status. Now, if I wanted to, I could be a so-called mad cunt. Okay, I see all these fucking heroes at Vanilla, and it makes me fucking sick. It makes me fucking sick. You know, they are tryhards. I know a lot of tryhards. A lot of them that live around me, that hang out at Vanilla. Okay. I know a lot of them that hang out outside Dream Cafe. Alright. Nikos is actually pretty good. Can't really say much about the cafe with no name. But you get tryhards all over the place. And women go for tryhards. Women go for tryhards. But you know what? They are see-through. And these women, they're just not quality girls anyway. I mean, sure, their throat's going to be good quality when you're fucking it. You know? They got great legs to spread them. They got great ass to fuck. But they're not quality girls inside. And God knows how much they headfuck them. And they probably headfuck the girls too. But I'm not like that. I am a very, very humble human being. I am from a different breed. I don't drink, I don't smoke, I don't do drugs. You know, and I don't light up a cigarette just to be social. You know, I don't light up. I got a mate that likes to, he calls himself a bit of a casual smoker. He's not a casual smoker. He doesn't light up a cigarette in a month. But when he goes out, he'll spark one up. He buys a deck and it lasts him 3 months. I don't understand why people have to, you know, light up a cigarette just to fit into a group, just to social. That's fake, man. You know, that is fake when people do that. You know, I've wanted to socialize, so I've gone and sat down and I've said a couple words, but I didn't go and bum a cigarette and sit there and smoke with them just so I can fit in and social. Hey, you know what the fucked up thing is? This is how fucked the world is, ladies and gentlemen. If you do that, if you're a fake cunt and you do that, it actually works. Do you believe that? It actually works. You're going to bum a cigarette off a girl, you're going to sit down, they're going to get to know you. Next thing you know, they want to suck your left testicle and your right fucking testicle. But, you know, because I don't drink, I don't smoke, you know, I am not cool. I am not fucking cool. Because I don't drink and I don't smoke. Really? I'm not cool because I don't drink and I don't smoke. Really? Okay. Alright. And you know what really shits me? And you know, this is what takes the cake. Hell, this takes the doesn't even take the shop. I was going to say the shop of cakes. This takes the trucks. Those massive semi-fucking trailers that are delivering the cakes from interstate. What really shits me is, because you know, I've got tats. I've got quite a number of tats. My upper arms are covered. You know, I'm going to keep going. I love tats. I don't love them for the reasons that most tryhard wannabe fucking poofters get them. But I love them, okay, because they're cool. They're cool. They're the form of art. Not in some sort of tryhard, sick cunt way. I like them. They're nice. I dig them. And I've got tats, and, you know, they see that online. And, you know, they meet up with me. You know, they sit there and have a couple of coffees. You know, we sit there a couple hours. They hear how nice I am. They hear that I don't have a deep voice. Hey, fully sick here. I went down the road. Oh, my God. Oh, shit, man. He ran like no tomorrow. Oh, mate, I would have had him. I tell you what, if no one was around, I would have clipped him behind the ear, mate. I don't talk like a fucking dickhead, man. I don't talk like a dickhead. Alright, I don't talk like a fucking tryhard wannabe. Alright, I don't deepen my voice box just to sound tough. Alright? So, you know, I don't do that. Okay, I don't rip standstills. I don't do up my fucking car to make up for the short dick that I fucking have. I don't do any of that. But women like that shit. They like that superficial shit. They love all of that type of crap. All that stuff is materialistic garbage. Ah, but you know, girls like it. That's how you get to a woman's cunt, by doing shit like that. You know, I never necessarily wanted to go for a woman's cunt. You know, I just want to sit down, have a coffee and pick her brain, but no, I never make it that far. You know, the night usually ends early and that's that. The thing I hate is, they go for me initially because they see I got the tats, I fit the bad boy stereotype, but when they see that I'm completely different, okay, that I'm not one of these fucking drop kicks, they don't want a bar of me after that. For fuck all reason, man. They just don't want a bar of me. And that really shits me, man. And I know I'm not fucking ugly. I know I'm not fucking ugly. Because trust me, man. And I say this in the most humble way. Because I'm not fucking shallow. But trust me. I've seen some pretty fucking ugly motherfuckers. I have. I've seen some. And I am going to fucking call them ugly. I know it sounds mean. But I am going to fucking call them ugly. Because they've got every ability to make themselves look better. And they just love being the way that they are. They love being a slob. And I, you know, and they are fucking ugly, man. And I say that because it's the truth. I've met a lot of fucking ugly people. And I'm not ugly, okay? I'm not ugly. I consider myself pretty average. Pretty average at best. And I've got a heart of gold. So that's not stopping me, trust me, okay? That doesn't stop me, okay? People see me on Facebook, they see me in videos, they know what I look like. It's no secret. I've got fucking a million videos on YouTube. So, they meet up with me. But the problem is, they don't give a nice fucking guy a chance. Why do most girls prefer the bad boys? This is something that I want answered, ladies and gentlemen. Okay, I've opened up a brand new Facebook. Okay, I've got a new profile. I've got my page, okay, which has 30,000 fucking likes. Okay, in real life, I barely have 3 friends. Okay, but I've got 30,000 likes on my page on Facebook. I've got several thousand on Twitter. They use Twitter much, so I don't really have that many. But I want someone on there. Okay, even on my new profile, it's starting to fill up. I want people to comment below this video and explain to me why women prefer the bad boys. Why? What's so appealing about a fucking tryhard? Explain it to me so I can understand. What is so appealing about a fucking tryhard? They run in a pact. Okay, tryhards, if it's just them, okay, if you see someone at a service station, okay, you know, pumping some fuel, alright, and you rock up there in your vehicle and you spot him, you get out, he's on his own, he's gonna fucking bolt inside, he's gonna pay for the fucking thing, okay, he's gonna get out, and then he's gonna fuck off straight away before I even get a chance to say something to him, alright, but if they're in a pact, if they're all together, he's gonna get out, stand like a mad cunt, pump the fuel in his fucking V8, alright, and then he's gonna go, he's gonna walk slowly like a sick cunt, he's gonna get inside, pull the door, he's gonna, you know, wait in line, you know, take his time looking at the lollies or looking at the slurping machine, even though the line is empty, he's gonna take his time, you know, he's gonna walk and then he's gonna pay for it, he's gonna come out the front, he's gonna rip out a cigarette, he's gonna smoke with the whole group around there, a few other cars will be parked in front, they're gonna kick it outside 7-Eleven for a good 15-20 minutes, and then, oh, they'll give the guy, you know, the Indiano, they'll give him a bit of shit inside 7-Eleven, you know, they'll, from outside, they'll poke fun at him. Then they're going to finally get in their cars, they're going to rev their cars a little bit, they're not going to go straight away, they're going to rev their cars a little bit just to look like mad cunts. You know, they're going to loiter around for a little bit and then they're going to finally drive off. Okay? See, but if they're on their own, they're not going to do that, are they? Who the fuck on their own would rock up to a 7-Eleven. You tell me if you've seen people do this. They get out, do their thing, get back in, fucking show off, rev their fucking car or their bikes or whatever the fuck they rock up in. Who does it if they're on their own? They don't. They don't stick around. Because if it's not someone that they know rocks up to confront them, it's going to be some random cunt saying, get the fuck out of here. What the fuck are you doing? They run in a pact. You tell me what's so fucking cool about that. Oh, they run in a pact. Oh, they're awesome. Well, you know what? The NWO Wolfpack in WCW was awesome. Alright, the Wolfpack. Woo! Alright? And they ran in a pack. They used to beat up people. But you know what? That's acting. That's fake. That's television. That's scripted. This is real life, ladies and gentlemen. And in real life, any one of those people on their own, okay, they don't stand a chance in a one-on-one fight. They don't even stand a chance to back themselves up. They have no fucking confidence to go up to someone and arc up. I do, though. I don't give a fuck, mate. Hey, don't get me wrong. I don't go around starting fights at all. Oh, mate, not a single fight. I am a very, very good fucking humble human being. I'm a very fucking humble human being. But I'll tell you what, man, if trouble comes my way, I bring it. I fucking bring it. I don't hold back, man. I fucking speak up. I fucking let them have it. On my own, man. On my fucking own. I don't act up when there's people around, because that just makes you look weak. It really makes you look weak if you're arcing up, you know, around a fucking group. And it makes you look like you're a person who can't hold you cool. And, you know, like, it's not good, man, to get angry and shit. But if it's one-on-one, and you've got someone in a back alleyway, if you've got someone on the side street, and they want to go you, oh, mate, I let loose. Most of these other people, like I said, they see someone, okay, hell, they see their own shadow, and they fucking bolt. So, I don't know what's so cool about these tryhards, ladies. I have no idea what's so, you know, amazing about them. All I know is that's what all these fucking women go for. They don't go for a decent fucking guy. You know, if you're not going to go for a great guy like me, at least go for someone who's decent. At least, you know, go for someone who's got his head screwed on right. But you can't even settle for that. You can't even settle for a decent type of guy. He has to have a real fucking bad streak. It's not enough to have a bit of an edge. Because I've got a bit of an edge. Hell, I've got a real fucking edge for people that know me. Now, if you know me, Jesus fucking Christ, mate, I've got a real fucking edge. But I'm not a fucking tryhard. I'm not one of these fucking pussy cunts out there that act all big. You know? Just so they can act cool, man. Like, what the fuck? You don't have to... having tats doesn't make you cool. Having earrings doesn't make you fucking... Having a lip ring doesn't make you cool. You know, but if you want to go all out, you get piercings all over the place. And, you know, if your whole body's covered in tats, well, it shows you're a pretty extreme motherfucker. Because no one in the right state of mind would do all that stuff. Well, they wouldn't get covered in fucking tats and get, you know, like... You know, there's just something, you know, different about them. But your average Joe that loves to get tats and pose in the mirror with them, and that's ridiculous. You know who the hard cunts are, and usually you pick them before they even show you their tats, before they take off their top and you see all their tats. They could be dressed in a suit, and just by looking at their expressions, looking at how they act, you'll know they're fucking hard cunts. Because they are, there are hard cunts out there, they do exist, you know? But all this materialistic shit, you know, people love materialistic fucking shit. It's a fucking disgrace, man. What kind of world do we fucking live in, man? You know, they don't like people that are nice and quiet and humble and, you know, awesome to be around. They like people that are just out there, man. You know, like, you know, personality is just out there. You know, they hang out with groups. They run in a pact. You know, if you ever need them for something, they're a call away. They'll get down 10 carloads. You know, they know everyone at the cafe. Oh, yeah, you're a mad cunt. You know everyone at a coffee shop. Oh, you're a mad cunt. Everyone knows you're at a coffee shop. You're a mad cunt. Yeah, oh, I want to suck his dick tonight. Oh, yeah. Chicks will be all over him. Women are fucking retarded, man.